I have the Redmi Note 13 Pro here from Xiaomi, and today I'll be showing you how to perform a factory data reset on this device, as well as all other devices in this series. There are actually a lot of reasons why someone would want to perform a data wipe on their smartphone. Perhaps the Android operating system is sluggish and they're wanting it to be wiped clean. Maybe you have plans to sell the device and need all of your data to be erased. You may even be currently experiencing a bootloop due to Android file system corruption. So going through with a factory data reset may be your only way forward. No matter the reason, I can show you how to reset these devices in the series, including the Redmi Note 13 4G. The first method that I'll be showing you here today is how to factory reset the device via the Settings menu. So this works by first launching the Settings application, and then from here, we're going to tap into the My Device section. Now, you'll want to look for the Factory Reset option down here toward the bottom. And then you're going to see this Erase All Data button at the bottom. You're going to want to tap that, and then you'll want to confirm if that's actually what you want to do, just in case you made it into this menu by accident. But this will erase all of the data from your phone, including the Redmi Note 13R. And here's a quick tip about this. If you aren't able to find that option where I showed you in these menus, then Xiaomi may have updated the operating system firmware. So you could also go to the top of the Settings application and then searching for the word reset. From here, you should find the factory data reset page instantly. Now, another method to performing a factory data reset on the Redmi Note 13 Pro Plus is via recovery mode. I have already done a dedicated video on how to access recovery mode with this device, so I do recommend checking out that guide, which will be linked in the video description below. However, you can access this by first going to reboot the device and then holding the volume up button while the phone boots back up. If everything is done correctly, then you should see the phone go from the Redmi boot logo into Xiaomi's HyperOS recovery mode. From this menu, we can factory reset the Redmi Note 13 by using the volume button to make sure the wipe data option is highlighted, and then pressing the power button to select that option. From this screen, again, we want to use the volume down button to make sure the wipe all data option is highlighted, and then pressing the power button to select it. This time, when you proceed, you will see all of your data has been erased, and that will help you to fix a boot loop and access Android again. The last method that I'll be showing you here today is how to wipe the data of the Redmi Note 13 Pro via Fastboot Mode, which again, this can be useful if your phone is currently in a boot loop and you are unable to access the Settings application within Android. But before any of this will work, you will need to have ADB and Fastboot tools installed on your PC. A desktop computer or a laptop is required for this method, so if you don't have access to one, then you'll want to try another method I mentioned in this video. I'll even have a tutorial linked below that will show you how I install ADB and Fastboot on my PC. So I have the Redmi Note 13 Pro in Fastboot mode. I have it connected to the PC with a USB cable. And you're going to want to double click on the desktop shortcut if you have installed ADB and Fastboot++, or you'll simply want to open a terminal window, a command prompt, or a Windows PowerShell within the same folder as your ADB and Fastboot tools. That part is important because we're going to be executing a Fastboot command, so this command prompt needs to be in that same folder. Now, to make sure we have a proper connection, we're going to execute the command fastboot space devices and press enter. Now, if you get a response like this with your serial number and the term fastboot, then that means it worked correctly. However, if you're told that there is no device, then you'll need to install the proper USB ADB drivers for Xiaomi devices. Any quick Google search should point you in the right direction for what to download. When you're ready, we can perform a factory data reset on the Redmi Note 13 series by executing the command fastboot space erase space user data. Be sure this is what you want to do though, because again, this will wipe all of your data from your phone in an attempt to get the Android operating system working again. This method is also going to require that you have the bootloader unlocked, and the command is fastboot space erase space user data and press enter. As you can see here, my device is not bootloader unlocked, so I'm getting an error. And if that's the case for you, then you're going to want to reboot into recovery mode and perform the factory data reset with that method. And the quickest way I can recommend doing that is executing the command fastboot space reboot space recovery and pressing enter. That will reboot your Redmi Note 13 and boot you over into recovery mode. No matter which method you go with, your smartphone will go through a data wipe, and that will result in a reboot. When your phone boots back up, you will be brought to the Android activation screen where you can set everything back up again. You will need to log into your Xiaomi or Google accounts again if you had logged into any previously, and then you can start using your phone like normal. If anyone has any questions about this process, or just about Android in general, then do not hesitate to use the comment section below. For anyone still watching, it would help out a lot if you liked this video and subscribe to the channel. Here you'll find more content about the Redmi Note 13 series, as well as Android news in general.